good now to whoever and wherever you are across the world. I hope this video finds you doing well, preferably splendastic, or even better. But in the off chance that you're not doing too well, hopefully by the time this video is over, you will be well on your way to feeling not bad, pretty good, awesome, amazing, fantastic, splendastic, or any one of the, or many of the infinite number of adverbs and adjectives to describe such an immense and celestial state of complete and total bliss. It's just incomprehensible or impossible to describe to us little humans on this planet. Okay, so at least I think, you know, you're real. It's possible that or everything isn't rendered into existence until it's within eyesight and audio range. At least that's what the simulation theory would have us lead us to believe. But we're not going to talk about that. What we will be talking about is, as you have probably surmised from the title of this video, is how much are we in control when it comes to our own minds and bodies, if we're in control at all, and even bigger than that, has every thought, every action, our entire lives, even the universe itself, already happened? So, we'll get into that in just a moment, but before we do, as far as I can tell, this life seems very, well, it has some complex aspects to it, science, things like that. I wake up, you know, there's weather patterns, and maybe the sun is out. If there's, you know, maybe I can see the sun, there's no clouds, and, you know, it's the morning, because that's just where I live, and based on the Earth's rotation, and the part of the Earth facing the sun, and the Earth rotates and is a globe and rotates itself and rotates around the sun, right? And I feel pain and different emotions, and when I'm hungry, I eat, or I want to eat when I'm hungry, and I make decisions in my life based on hunger and thirst, and, you know, it gets a little more stressful and complicated when it comes to things like finances. Where's my job, right? And I have to make all these decisions and navigate the world, you know, based on information that I take in. I want to eat something. Do I want to eat something because I'm not feeling too well, and I want to, like, angry eat, so to speak, or do I want to watch what I eat and eat a little more healthier? Okay, and the decisions that I make feel very real. They're happening right now. I'm making this video right now, and this was a decision that I feel I'm somewhat consciously aware of and chose to make. And I'm doing this video, you're watching it, you know, these decisions are happening right now. We have memories of things that have happened. We call that the past. Things that are happening right now is the present. And then things that have yet to happen is the future. and it feels like the future is unknown. That these decisions, things are just happening right now. I'm moving my hands. I'm looking down. Now I'm looking up. You're paying attention. You're watching the video. You're just listening. And these things are just unfolding right now, live. Okay? It feels very real, authentic, rational. Okay? So just life, has its complex aspects, science and biology and blah, 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 but it also seems quite simple. There is no God, as far as I can tell. There is no alien. There might be life on other planets in the universe, but there is no aliens visiting us on their spaceships. And, the only evidence we ever have of UFOs is always crappy footage or the things you really can't make out what they are. Nothing ever real close up in detail and large and to actually determine if it's a real UFO. It's always, always doctored and whatever. So there's no conclusive evidence of UFOs, cryptids, Bigfoot, God, etc. From this perspective, okay, from this human being's perspective. So life feels just very raw, real, authentic. Nothing, there might be things we don't know, but sometimes science will uncover those things. Right? So there's no mystery as far as God creating the universe. Somehow the universe came about, and there's just, there's energy, there's the sun continues to burn for billions of years before it dies out. The earth continues to spin. We continue to live our lives, make decisions, and right in the moment it feels very real. Feels very real and raw and authentic, okay? So I wanted to say all that because I know that, because that's pretty much the reality for all of us. We wake up, gotta go to school, gotta go to work, brush your teeth, eat, make all these decisions, So, and we don't really often think about the topics in this video or in, many of our other videos. A lot of these metaphysical or scientific or philosophical topics, while they're great to ponder, they always don't help answer things, right? So it's great. Oh, that's great. They're, anarchism this or nihilism that. Well, you know what? I still need to eat. I still need a job. So while these philosophies can help answer some maybe internal questions about life and existence, we still have to live our lives. So they're not so much helpful with getting a job or eating, right? But they can help with anxiety and stress. So I wanted to start off with that because I know some of these topics can seem just not so much far-fetched, but they can get, at least for me, I'm a simple person, and they can get a little too much for me, especially the quantum physics of things. And then some of these topics seem like almost ridiculous because when we talk about whether or not we're in control, well, of course I'm in control. I made the decision to make this video. You made the decision to watch or listen. We make thousands of decisions all throughout our lives. Gotta go to work, gotta go to school. Let me get my pencil and start taking a test. I have to go to the bathroom because my body says it's time to relieve itself. I have to eat because I'm hungry, right? And so on and so forth. I lost my train of thought there real quick as far as what I was just momentarily talking about. So life seems very simple, very real, authentic, in the moment, right? Decisions and all this. And, of course, course I'm in control. Of course we're in control, right? And then you talk about, what do you mean, has everything already happened? No, nothing has. No, I haven't lived my entire life yet. I'm still making decisions, so there's no such thing as the future. The future will happen once I make decisions and once everything else that's happening now happens, right? So whatever I'm about to say after this sentence is the future. Now here we are. This is what I was going to say a moment ago. Now it's the present. And now what I said, you know, just a moment ago is the past, right? So there's this constant flow. It seems like there's a constant flow. There's no future. If there is a future, we don't know about it. So how could everything that has in our lives already happened, right? And that's ridiculous, preposterous, okay? And so that's why I wanted to open this video with the fact that, you know, these thoughts and about quantum physics and Einstein's box theory, something like that, where past, present, and future exist all at the same time, time is an illusion, etc. These things can seem like, you know, okay, maybe they have some plausibility, but they don't seem real. What seems real is, you know, me making decisions, you making decisions, things happening, and, you know, there is a past, perhaps based on memories. The future hasn't yet happened, and everything feels real. I'm starting to repeat myself, but I hope you understand that just, you know, you and I, and probably so many people throughout the world, don't often pause to think about, has everything already happened? Right? And am I really in control? And we, you know, some of us might think about it, but then, you know, you snap back to reality. Oh, I gotta cook dinner. Oh, I gotta do this and this. It feels very real. This feels like the truth, right? So what is the truth, right? That's kind of like the ultimate question, because we're just products of the universe. We didn't create the universe. We only perceive things based on this organic computer, powerhouse of a computer, of a powerhouse of an organic computer, which perceives everything based on information, external information it receives through vision, hearing, smell, taste, and then it stores information as memories, mostly for survival, right? So when you know where there's food, or there's a major event, or something scary, it records that, so you know either, you know, oh, that's how I'll get my food again, or that's something to avoid not getting injured, etc. All right. And I probably should have said what I'm about to say now, earlier in the video, but I have been thinking about this topic. Are we in control? Has everything already happened? Off and on through the years, but more recently, you know, a couple of weeks or so prior to the date of this video. But, you know, at some point throughout my life, I've had these thoughts. I don't know how far back did I have them, when I was a teen. You know, it's possible. I got a quick little thought, and then, you know, I've been daydreaming and thinking ever since I was a kid and zoning out in school. You know, I don't have a recollection of every time I've had one of these types of thoughts, but over the last few weeks, I've had these thoughts a little more on a more daily basis, and maybe I'm here because the decision was made a few weeks ago, and, you know, here we are, and this is happening, and maybe this was meant to happen, and it gets uploaded to my channel and you see it, and you know, it's almost like everything that I've done and decisions that I've made were decisions that were meant to happen. So, but we'll get into that in a minute. But first, let's talk about, are we in control? And then we'll move towards the more metaphysical, quantum physics, philosophical question, has everything already happened? But real quick, based on some theories, there's thought, holding up a CD disc, in case you're just listening, a DVD, whatever, that our lives and that everything that's ever happened, but especially our lives, are like a movie on a disc. It has the start and it has the end. You know, you can almost consider this like time. Everything that's happened in our lives is like on a disc. It has the beginning, the end, and everything that happens between. And so, therefore, what we're experiencing right now is just, we're kind of the passenger experiencing what's has already happened, is going to happen, and we're not really that much in control, but we'll get into that, okay? So, let's talk about, are we in control when it comes to decisions and, you know, our thoughts and our own body? So, obviously, we're not in control in terms of certain body functions that our brain is kind of the command center in charge of, right? We don't have to breathe. The breathing is automated. The processing of nutrients, the blood flow, the heart pumping, the lungs, right, contracting, expanding, the motor functions. I mean, I might decide to move my arm and hand like this, but I'm not actually telling my muscles, right, like, okay, this, you know, bicep, do this, you know, ligaments, you know, blah, blah, blah. I just think that I want to move my hand and arm like this, and it happens. I don't have to control all the muscles. I don't have to consciously be aware of anything, right, except for wanting to move. So motor functions, you know, our brain controls those based on, you know, like all these movements I'm doing, I'm not consciously aware of moving all the muscles as I talk to you, blinking. You know, I blink. That's involuntary. So many involuntary processes that are happening, right? And that we're not in control of. When we get hungry, when we get thirsty, we're not in control of that. Fear, anxiety, we're not in control of that. You can try to control them after they've occurred, or you can take steps in your life to try to control certain things to minimize anxiety and fear from cropping up, but you know, you can't really control that and make it go away. So there's a lot of, you know, when we said breathing, heart, the nervous system itself, all the signals being passed, not just within all the different synapses and the neural network of the brain itself, but all the, you know, all the different parts of the body that communicate between the brain and the stomach and the heart and the liver, etc. Right? So yeah, right, the liver, the different organs of our body. We don't have to consciously think about how liquid is processed and how our liver functions and our kidneys function and all that, right? So there is a large part of our body body and our minds, same thing, that we're just not in control of. Okay. Now is where the topic of this, the first thing I want to talk about, are we in control when it comes to decisions? And a lot of this you can Google yourself and you'll find similar questions and answers, quote, answers, as much as we can tell what the answers are. Well, what is the truth, right? But as far as we can tell, when it comes to are we in control of decisions, am I really in control of doing this video on this topic? Are you really in control of wanting to watch this video? Okay. Again, let's go back to what I started this video with and talked about for the first 5 minutes or so. This life feels very real, authentic. I'm making decisions right now. I want to talk about what I want to talk about. You consciously feel as though you chose to watch this video or to listen or both or neither or a combination of any. Sometimes not listening, sometimes watching, sometimes not watching or listening. Okay. Anyway, so when it comes to decisions, I'm pretty sure it's a fact that all the decisions that we feel we're consciously making, right? The arrogance or the what's the word when you're, you know, think you're the boss and you're in control, not bravado. That's another word ending in S, I think. I can't think of it. It'll probably come to me. So we think we're in control, right? Oh, I chose to talk about this video. You chose to watch it. You chose not to watch it, whatever. But those decisions have already happened a split second, a few milliseconds before we are consciously aware of them. So it's possible that all the decisions that we make, that it's possible that our entire lives, from decision to decision, day to day, that everything about our lives is completely out of our control, 100%. And that we are not in control of anything, even though we're consciously aware that we feel like we're in control, but we're not. So, for instance, you want to eat something for lunch today, or dinner, or you want to grab a snack, whatever time of the day it is, right? And you feel that you want to get something to eat, and you're in control of that decision, and you're going to eat, you know, whatever it is. And you're eating it, and you're in control of that decision. Well, that decision was already made of what you were going to eat based on the information that you have on what you have to eat where you live. And if you don't have anything you want, which is another decision that's probably already been made, you will go and get whatever it is that your brain really wants. So it's almost like we're riding in the passenger seat, and that this brain, this, you know, 3 or 5 pounds of meat and its complex network of, you know, neural network of synapses and everything, billions of synapses, I think, if not trillions, so many decisions, so many things going on all throughout the day, so many functions, it's mind-boggling. But all the decisions, this thing is in control. So if we were sitting in a car, this would be driving, and we would just be probably in the back seat, not even in the passenger side, probably in the back seat, right? And so when this thing says, oh, I want to eat, I've decided to eat McDonald's, it's not healthy, but I'm going to do it anyway because I feel depressed or I'm angry. I'm going to eat based on those emotions. and you're in the back seat saying, no, we shouldn't do that. It's not healthy, you know, but you do it anyway. So are we really in control? I mean, I'm making this video. I feel I'm consciously aware of wanting to make this video, but that decision was already made deep inside my brain based on whatever something is in my brain is saying to make this video. Something deep down in, you know, the core of my brain is deciding each word or, you know, concept. You know, something in my brain has already decided the words that I'm going to say, what I'm going to say next, so on and so forth. Every decision is happening before I'm consciously aware of it. So I think, and, you know, that we are not in control at all. You know, I'm not 100%. Again, this feels very real. It feels like I'm in control. It feels like I'm making the decisions. Like I have the ability to change decisions, but maybe my brain is the one that's changing what's going to happen next as it processes information. And so, you know, what is, you know, we can get into what consciousness is, right? But what is this awareness that I have? I have this brain. We have these brains that are, you know, control everything, even decision making. And that would explain a lot of things that happen in the world, whether good or bad, especially some of the bad things, the horrible things. Some people's brains are making decisions to do things that you and I, and a lot of us would never do in terms of some certain crimes, horrible crimes. Some, you know, and we call those mental health issues, but those people, for whatever reason, they don't have the conscious awareness or ability to say, or the whatever it is that creates a sense of moral and ethic within our minds to say, I probably shouldn't do that. I probably shouldn't go and you know, do these horrible things. And so their brain is making those decisions and they're just kind of carrying them out. It's like we're just carrying out the orders of what this thing wants. And then you think about, well, how about the job? Or the fact I'm going to school and I'm choosing to go to school for a certain subject, or the job that I'm working or I want to work. But again, and pardon, my stomach is a little, you know, my stomach is a little vocal today, so pardon any stomach sounds. Real quick, did you know that our, speaking of stomach, that our stomachs way back prior to us evolving into primates, I mean, way, I don't know how many billions of years you need to go back, but our stomachs were the first brain. And then it wasn't until later in our evolution that this brain, the brain in our skull, is the second brain. I'm not sure if that is a theory or a fact. This was something that I saw years ago on a documentary, about 5 years ago, maybe. So you can Google that. The two brains. We have the brain in our skull and the stomach brain. So it's possible we have these two brains, so to speak, that drive, right? So our stomach or our intestines, the lower brain, so to speak, is maybe what drives us to eat or drink, right? And then the higher brain, the newer brain, newer evolved brain, is what has the fear instincts, decision making, controls the nervous system, all of that. So that's something to look into if you're curious about that. I'm not just making it up. All right, so let's go back to, I lost my train of thought, but so it's possible that we're just not in control at all. And I don't mean like some of us, like you think, well, we're not in control, then why aren't we all killing and fighting each other? Because we're not in control. So some of us have healthy brains, so to speak, that know that we shouldn't just kill or for no reason. Whether that's because how we were raised, it's because of the threat of going to jail. So our brain has all this information, and so why do I have I lived for 50, soon to be 53 years and haven't murdered anyone? Because my brain has all the information it needs to make a decision on a moment-to-moment basis every day, even when I'm angry, to not murder for whatever reason. I have, a lot of us, most of us have the healthy kind of brain, but I'm still not even in control. I might think that I'm not killing because or murdering anyone because I'm in control. It's right and it's wrong, or it's wrong. It's not ethical, blah blah blah. But it's really my brain that's making that decision, or has that concept, is aware of that on a daily basis. But that's just one aspect, right? So the job, or the you decide to go to college, and you feel you're consciously aware of all that. Oh, come on, I gotta be in control. I'm in control of my destiny and my future and the plan. I don't think so. I think all the information that our brains take in dictate what it wants and what it desires, perhaps. And we're just kind of, this is just a vessel to carry out the orders of our brain. And so we're not really in control at all of our lives. I mean, our brain, we watch what we want to watch, to laugh, or it's interesting because our brain, deep down, the synapses have already decided what they want to do moment to moment based on dopamine, the feeling of dopamine or serotonin, whatever it might be. And then it's not until a split second later we're consciously aware of, oh yeah, I want to watch this movie. But that does, but your brain is figured out about this new trailer for a movie or for a video game, and it makes the brain excited, and there's a dopamine release maybe, or serotonin. I'm not an expert on those. And now it's like, okay, I want that. Okay, at some point, when the brain knows you have the money for it, it keeps track of that as well. I think I'm keeping track of my finances, but what is we? What is I? This. And all the millions of, billions of synapses that record all the information that we're aware of, that our bank account and where the food is, what we have in the fridge, what we don't have, what I want right now, what's going to make me happy, how am I going to handle this, blah, 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 just. Right, so it's a record keeper, an accountant, decision-making machine. And this conscious awareness, which is kind of the awareness and consciousness, that's kind of the cerebral cortex. That's what happens there, if I'm not mistaken. The cerebral, right? The brain, there's a glitter on the brain. I'm not sure if you can see it, but just ignore that. There are aspects of the brain which evolved first. You can consider them the lizard brain, primal instincts, fight or flight, fear, reproduction, all of that. That's like the core of the brain, right down here where the brain stem starts. Okay. Then all this stuff, these wrinkly parts, evolved later during the course of our evolution. And this is where decision-making, less instinct and consciousness awareness kind of takes place, if I'm not mistaken. But even though we are conscious and we have awareness of decisions that we make and all that, they're still made before we're consciously aware of them. That's kind of the, if that's not fact, it's a leading theory. And I'm kind of buying into that. I've been alive for 53 years and, you know, things happen. And sometimes it just feels like, you know, you're going along for the ride. And if we're to give any credence to what we're going to talk about next, in regards to our lives, past, present, and future, existing all at the same time, like on a CD, right? And I know it's kind of hard to think about that. If how can the future already exist if I haven't made all those decisions yet? But it's just a theory of, I don't know if it's a quantum physics theory or a theory of relativity. But it's possible that, you know, my life, my death, everything is already played out, and I'm just kind of along for the ride. You know, who knows what chapter I'm on in the DVD of my life. But, you know, I'm just kind of along. It sounds crazy, right? What do you mean? Just, no, I can't just be some kind of, you know, automaton that doesn't. I'm very consciously aware. I want to play this video game. I want to watch this movie. Yeah, well, that decision was already made for you in deep in the core of your brain or on the surface somewhere in the cerebral cortex. I don't know where the decisions actually occur. And then we become consciously aware of them. And then maybe based on the conscious awareness, further decisions are made. So it's decision after decision after new information after decisions, after debating decisions, and, you know, and we're just not in control. So I'm part of me is like, you know, it just can't be. I gotta be in control of my decisions. But am I really? Right? Maybe I'm not. Maybe not. So that's why I'm here, to ask, you know, what do you think about that? Do you feel like this is nonsense? I'm in control. Or do you think, you know, it's possible? Or are you like a firm believer that, yeah, we're not in control of anything? All of the decisions are taking place in our brain. And then we just become consciously aware of them for whatever reason. Maybe consciousness and awareness is just a side effect of having a higher evolved brain. We're just aware of the decisions, but that doesn't mean we're in control of them. You know, maybe we are just, and like I said, it sounds crazy. I am in control of the decision. If I want to stand up all of a sudden, step away from the camera, you know, talk to you over here, you can kind of barely hear me, but, you know, I feel like I'm making this conscious decision if I want to take this little brain and just toss it around and be silly and be goofy and make silly. I'm making all these decisions, right? Wave my hands around, you know, dress up as a plague doctor, run a YouTube channel, quit my real life job and take a risk and, you know, somehow I'm still able to, you know, do all this stuff on YouTube. Right? I'm in control, right? It can't be that my brain is the one that desires all these things. My brain, well, you know, I just stepped away from the microphone. I just made a silly face. I just tossed the brain around. That was me, right? Or was those decisions happening so quick in my brain in order to explain what is going on and we're talking about? So, are we in control? I don't know. You know, it's part of me wants to be like, you know, I gotta be in control. There's no way that my life is completely automated and I'm just like a passenger aware of decisions being made, you know, by myself, and I just, every decision next to next is not even me. It's my brain making the decision for me based on so many factors. Am I hungry? What do I want to eat? What do I want to do? How much is the desire for dopamine or serotonin driving the decisions? Hunger driving my decisions? Thirst? Responsibilities? Finances and so many things that sometimes feel like we overcomplicate life, and the decisions can be too much because life is not simple anymore and overly unnecessarily complex, more complex than it needs to be. But are we in control? You know, are we in control of our lives and what's going on with our brains and the decisions that we make? I don't know. Maybe not at all. I'm not the only one to raise that question. You can Google that yourself and enjoy all the different people that have thought about that and try to provide answers to it. All right, so now we're going to move on to has everything already happened, which is kind of related to are we in control? So we're going from like a micro kind of look and thoughts about our lives down here at the micro scale, right? When you think about the universe, how vast the universe is, our lives are so insignificant in terms of the scope and the breadth of the universe and how big it is and how all different bodies of stars and planets are much bigger than Earth, for example. And so we are human, our lives and every organism on this planet, even though there is like billions and trillions of organisms, we're all like grains of sand on a beach. Or actually not all the grains of sand. If you were to go down to a beach, there's probably a certain amount of sand on that beach that would correlate to the amount of life on this planet. And then you have the rest of the beach. So, I mean, you know, think of how small a grain of sand is, you know. So we are insignificant. I'm not saying you're insignificant, and I'm insignificant in terms of the lives that we live, right? But in the grand scheme of things. So when you look at things from the big picture, right, that's... I'm not sure if that's a macro view or what the word is, but whatever the word is for looking at the universe from a very, from the, you know, big picture aspect, where human beings and our individual lives so very, very infinitesimal, I hate that word, so very tiny and almost insignificant. You know, it's kind of like when you think about ants, how tiny they are, or the cells, and the white blood cells and the red blood cells in our bodies, or our synapses, so very small and insignificant. But when you get down to the micro level, or the macro, whatever, and you look at the white cell, the white blood cell, the synapse, the red blood cell, very close up, it's no longer insignificant. So from a micro, close-up, micro, macro aspect, you know, are we in control of our minds and our decisions moment-to-moment, day-to-day basis? But when you step back from that and look at things on a larger scale, and then you wonder, you know, are we in control not so much any longer about the decisions that we make, but in terms of everything that is ever going to happen, has it already happened? All right, so that's the next part of, I'm not sure if that was the best segue into things, but we're going to move away from looking at our lives at a very close-up micro level in terms of decisions, are we in control, to the bigger picture, and that is, has everything already happened that is ever going to happen? Now, I'm not going to get into the quantum physics of things in terms of past, present, and future don't exist. They all exist at the same time. That means the birth, the life we live, and our deaths have already happened. Okay, that stuff is a little bit beyond me. I start to read into, you know, I have a good grasp and ability to dig into things, but when you start getting to quantum physics and stuff, maybe just because I've never really taken the time to learn more about it, and then I always come to the conclusion of, well, okay, that's great, so maybe everything has already happened, but what's the point of even learning about that, because the present moment feels very real, and I still have to live, and I still have to make decisions on what I'm going to eat, where's my money coming from, paying my bills, going here or going there, day-to-day human life stuff. So you know, who really cares if I'm in control or not, or, you know, if everything has already happened. We still have to live these lives. It's not going to change anything, right? And so I get that, but now let's talk about it, right? So I'm not going to get into the quantum aspect of things and stuff like that because it's a little beyond my pay grade. But, you know, there is some thought and theory that everything that has ever happened in our lives or in the universe has already happened. Kind of like a show, a movie on a disc, right? The entire universe. And again, I gotta apologize for my stomach; it's being unruly. Everything, the entire universe, existence itself, might just be like a movie on a disc. There was a beginning. Maybe there will be an end. We don't know. But when it comes to our lives, especially, maybe the planet Earth, the sun, you know, you can just go to any point, you know, and that's part of the story that you'll get to. And we're just kind of going through the motions. We're just passengers along for the ride. Our deaths, whatever's going to happen in our lives has already happened. And so we're kind of just along for the ride and waiting to get there, waiting for the future to get here, so to speak, even though there might not be a future in terms of past, present, and future. There's just always now, pretty much. And the memories that we have of decisions we make, decisions our brain makes that we become consciously aware of, which we call the past, and things that have yet to happen, we call the future. But everything has already happened. So, and we're just kind of waiting to get there, so to speak. So it gets convoluted and stuff. And I'm not really here to get into all that, right? Because that's beyond my capacity, my brain power. Unless I, you know, I mean, anyone is capable of, almost anyone, despite any learning disabilities of learning about stuff, including quantum physics. I just have no interest in that stuff. Okay, so there's a lot to talk about when it comes to everything that has already, if everything that has already happened, right, that means that we're definitely not in control of any decisions we've made because our entire life has already happened. So that includes any decisions that our brain makes, which is kind of hard to wrap your mind. What do you mean? How is everything has already happened? It sounds ridiculous, but it's a theory. And when I look, you know, when I look at people's lives and things that happen that they do, you know, it's almost like everything that I was meant to do in my life was meant to happen in other people's lives. I know when you think about disease and cancer, like, what do you mean that person was meant to get cancer and die at a young age? Well, maybe that was meant to happen. Not that they were meant to suffer, but that's just that organism's life and how it was meant to play out. It's not fair. You know, I'm not really here to talk about the fairness of of life, and a lot of things are unfair. Some people, I'm still alive, and, you know, I'm very fortunate, and you can say I'm privileged. I mean, I didn't make a choice to be alive. I didn't make a choice for things, for a car accident to not happen. I'm not avoiding car accidents every day. You know, you talk about preordained or predetermination or fatalism, all these different things. You know, some people think that God, whatever God they believe in, has our life is already, you know, preordained or something. I don't believe in that. I kind of believe that everything has already happened. I'm not 100% sold on that. I just feel I don't want to start getting into like mysticism or spiritualism. I'm not really so much. I'm a very facts and rational and reasonable and type of person, right? So I don't think there's anything magical or mystical or spiritual, godly thing going on and in control. I think that when it comes to quantum physics, though, and, you know, because we only perceive things based on the fact that the universe gave birth to us, right? And we have these rudimentary eyes and ears to process information, but what is really the truth? How does the universe really function? We don't really know. We can only guess, make theories, and all that. But I kind of like the idea. I'm not 100% like, all right, just there's no point in even, you know, just sit back and watch everything unfold, you know, and don't get out of bed because that's what you were meant to do, or do this or do that. That's what you were meant to do. Everything's already happened. You know, it's kind of weird to think, but it's kind of weird to think that way. But I'm kind of sold on the fact that maybe things already happened, and I am kind of along for the ride. I mean, and just, it's kind of weird, but there's a couple of examples I'm going to think about or talk about. So let's talk about, you know, everything that has already happened, has happened, and how much we are in control. You've heard the term of the butterfly effect, right? You do something, and then it can cause an effect in another part of the world. Okay, a butterfly flaps its wings, causes a small little current, and then it creates a storm on the other side of the world, right? That's the butterfly effect. So I was thinking about this. What if, you know, I took my car, drove it out into the middle of an intersection, stopped it, got out of my car, and just kind of sat there and watched all the other cars, and I just caused a traffic jam, okay? And I caused a butterfly effect in all those people's lives. Now, I'm not here to talk about the butterfly effect. I'm here to talk about everything that has already happened, okay? So just stay with me. I'm trying to tell myself to stay with me so I don't get sidetracked. And I parked my car at a 4-lane intersection. I'm right in the middle. No one can go. Everybody's getting pissed off, honking their horns. Maybe someone's going to physically move me. Whatever. So I've caused all those people right there in front of all the other cars some aggravation, and all the other cars are starting to back up. I'm causing a butterfly effect. I have changed. I'm starting to change those people's, when they're going to get to work on time. I'm starting to alter their timelines, so to speak. However, I'm going to talk about this from first off, I haven't done that. So why haven't I? I'm thinking about it. I'm thinking about wanting to do something like that, but I haven't done it yet. Why? What's preventing me from doing it? Well, there's a lot of, you know, I don't want to do it because I don't want to get into an altercation. I don't want to get a ticket. So there's those things that my brain is aware about that is preventing me from actually doing that. But maybe I haven't done it yet, or maybe if I was to do that, that's another, it's already happened. So I haven't done it yet because it wasn't meant to be. It wasn't meant to happen yet. Even though me driving my car into the middle of an intersection, you know, causing some chaos, disrupting those people's lives, causing people to be late, you never know where everybody's going. It would alter. It's like a real experiment to do. It would alter a whole bunch of people's timelines, so to speak. However, if I was to drive that car into that intersection and alter those people's timelines, they're going to be late for work, they're pissed off, who knows how it's going to affect them for the rest of their lives. And that was meant to happen. So either I drive my car into the middle of an intersection, four-lane intersection, and I'm consciously aware of that, and I'm making that decision, and all the events that happen after, everybody else is consciously aware of. Maybe it makes the news. Who knows? Maybe I get shot and killed, right? Because you just never know who you're messing with, right? And that's just me making those decisions. Whatever, it's random. It wasn't meant to be. Or it was meant to be. It's already happened. And me following through with that, it's just being along for the ride. It was meant to happen. All those other people's lives who are impacted by me doing that was meant to happen. Okay. And there's all these kind of things happening all throughout the world so quickly, moment to moment, every day, a birth, a death, someone getting in a fight, someone getting married, divorced, graduating, flunking, failing, passing a test, failing a test, making friends, making enemies, you know, getting a job, getting laid off, and bugs eating each other. So it's just like you look at a pot of boiling water. That's like life on this planet, and every little pop bubble is a birth, is a death, is a graduation, is another life being eaten by another animal, is another life being born. Just every moment of the day is all these things that are happening all throughout the world. It's just so many organisms, not just so many trillions of organisms, but decisions being made as well. And all of it most likely has already happened and was meant to happen. So again, you know, we can talk about fatalism, and we can talk about quantum physics and predetermination or predestination and on, so many explanations to try to make sense of life. But, you know, has everything already happened? What is preventing me? I mean, I kind of know what's preventing me from driving my car into traffic and causing traffic jam, interrupting people's lives, and possibly forever changing some of those people's lives. You never know. Butterfly effect. But primarily the reason I haven't done that yet is just because of the risk involved, and I don't want to, kind of sounds crazy to do. Although I would like to do it for the experiment. And then if I was to actually go through with that, was that meant to happen? Has that already happened? If I actually go through with that at some point, was that meant to be? Has it already happened? And I'm just waiting for it to happen. You know what I'm saying? So there's all kinds of, has it already happened? Your life, how young you are, how much is decisions that you're making, and then how much is it that all your decisions all throughout your life has already happened, and you're just kind of along for the ride. So this part of the conversation or discussion or thought is kind of a little bit less involved than the decision making. I mean, there's not much to really talk about more. Has everything already happened? You'd have to get into the quantum physics stuff and Einstein's box theory or whatever the heck that is, where past, present, and future are taking place at the same time. It's life. life is almost black or white kind of thing when it comes to this entire discussion. Either nothing has ever happened and just events unfold. There is no future. There is no predetermination or fatalism or predestination or any of that. It's just chaos, and we are living these lives moment to moment, and there's no future that's, we are not along for the ride. We are going to make our future, so to speak, based on each decision that's occurring. And everything is real, and it feels very authentic, right? So that's on the one hand. We are kind of in control of decisions we make. So that's on the one hand. The other hand is everything that I've been bringing to question in this video. We're not making any decision. We're not in control, and everything has already happened. So it almost seems like, it has to be one or the other. It can't really be any gray area. Because even if you were to say, oh, well, I'm in control of all the decisions and all that, and if that's the truth, then everything that's already happened has yet to happen. Because if everything has already happened and we're just waiting to get to the end destination, then that means we're not in control of our decisions. All the decisions have already happened. And we're just kind of playing along. We're along for the ride. We're a backseat driver. And the universe and our brains are in control. So it's, or we are in control of decisions that we make. And if we are, then that would kind of dispel the everything has already happened theory. Because if we are in control of the decisions, then that means all the decisions that we ever make haven't happened yet. So I feel like it has to be one or the other. Like I said, I'm not looking to become a professor, an expert on these subjects or quantum physics, but I know enough about them. I did a little bit of research based on my own life experience and things I've experienced. Maybe that even explains deja vu, right? Deja vu is where you had the sense of something that's already happened. Oh, I've had this before. Maybe that's because your brain is kind of catching up to what has already happened. I remember a moment of deja vu in high school. We just got off a summer break. I think it was the first day back in high school. I'm not sure, junior year, freshman year, I don't remember. And I'm sitting around and we're having a discussion in homeroom class, and we're talking about a Pink Floyd concert that happened over the summer. We're talking about, I forget why. And I had this, and I'll never forget it to this day, that one of the most powerful moments of deja vu, that we had this conversation before. I just sat there like it was overwhelming sense of deja vu. Now, is it because, is it just my mind playing tricks on me? Because I'm just talking to these kids and I've talked about Pink Floyd before and it just seems like I had this, or, I'm making too much of a big deal of it, or, if we're going to think about everything that's already happened has happened, is this sense of deja vu, our minds kind of catching up to, I had this before, because it's that whole everything has already happened, which means I'm going to have that conversation about a concert over the summer, and I'm kind of catching up to that moment, and it's like, oh, wow, I don't know. I'm probably reading too much into it. So that's going to do it. I think I've touched on everything. What do you think? Do you think it's all bullshit? I'm making in control of my decisions and there's no future. It hasn't happened yet because I haven't made those decisions yet. And so on and so forth. Or do you give some thought, pause, and credence to what might be the fact that not only are we not in control of any decisions that we make. We're not in control of our lives at all. But in addition to that, our lives have already happened. Our deaths have already happened. Everything's almost like preordained, not by a higher power, but just by the way the universe works. All right? So that's what I've been thinking about. And if I happen to, and I'd love to hear what you think about it in the comments if you want. And as I think about this more often, or as I continue to think about it, we'll see where it leads us in the future, so to speak. And we might revisit this or, you know, see what some folks think. And who knows, maybe we'll get a video out of this or something, some kind of role play. All right, so thanks for tuning in. Thanks. It was great to have you. Stay well, stay safe, and I hope to see you in another video real soon. Until then, take care, and so long for now. Of course, if we end up seeing each other again and you tuning into a future video, it's probably because it already happened, and so it was meant to be, and, you know, and all that. So, you know, yeah. Now I have to edit this video, which was kind of already happened, and upload it, and you'll watch it. And, you know, and I'm actually talking in the past because this video was, you know, you are watching or listening to this video at whatever point in the quote-unquote future, which most likely has already happened. And it's starting to really hurt my brain at this point, so I think I'll stop.